We stand in awe. Amen. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. We are grateful that everyone is emerging out of their houses stronger, better, because we have a greater God, an awesome God. We praise you, we glorify you. We thank you for your protection. We thank you for your favor and your mercy over our lives. Glory be to your name. Lord, we honor you today. We glorify you. Thank you for our men and our women. Thank you for our children. Thank you for our friends. Even our sister visiting us today, we glorify you. We exalt you for bringing her and the whole family. We worship you on their behalf. Glory be unto your name. Thank you for every member of the church. Thank you for all our ministers. Thank you for those who are at home right now. We know that your presence will not leave them. We know that you will reach out by your spirit to touch them. And those who may be hearing us through the social media, online, Lord, we pray that the blessing and the favor of God will reach unto them now. Awesome God, bless your people today. Thank you for the answer. For in Jesus, marvelous, glorious, wonderful, eternal, immortal, invisible, El Shaddai, glorious, wonderful name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Sit down in the joy of the Lord. Amen. Glory be to God. We come this morning. I'm just going to go into the message, because the message simply says you have dominion. Say, I have dominion. No, this is not one of the messages that the pastor preached only. You preach it to yourself. I have dominion. I am a conqueror. In the name of Jesus. The power of God is with me. The grace of God is upon me. The Spirit of God is working with me. I am lifted up. I am empowered. I am far above principalities. I'm far above sickness. Corona has nothing on me. Sickness has nothing on me. Satan has nothing on me. I am enriched. I have dominion. And the dominion will be forever. I said the dominion of Christ in you will be forever. So shall it be in Jesus' name. I'd like to read to you from Isaiah chapter 14. It says, for the Lord will have mercy on Jacob, and will yet choose Israel, and set them in their own land. And the strangers shall be joined with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob. And the people shall take them, and bring them to their place. And the house of Israel shall possess them in the land of the Lord for servants and handmaids. And they shall take them captives, whose captives they were. Amen. Maybe I need to read that one to you again. You will take them captive, whose captive you are. Amen. Whose captive you are. Amen. You will take them captive. Amen. The Bible said God will take captivity captive. Now he's transferring that power to you. He's saying, by the word of the Lord, you will take captive whose captive you are, in the name of Jesus, and you shall rule over your oppressors. You shall rule over your oppressors. As we come to the month of September, we need to begin to assert our position in the Lord. We need to begin to talk of where we are in the Lord. You know, this morning they taught us about the millennial reign, about what Christ is going to do at the millennial, in the peace that is coming. But listen, you have the peace now. You have the joy now. Enjoy that peace now. The peace of God that passes all understanding is with you. The only thing that is not present, that is different from the millennial reign, you know, and now, is that even though the peace is being enjoyed by the individual, the whole world will be in peace when the millennial reign comes. That's the difference. Peace of God is with you. Grace of God is with you. Presence of God abides with you. Because when the presence of God shall come to the world, all evil and wicked things will be gone. But you have the presence now. So the enemy must have nothing on you. Christ said, the prince of this world cometh and he has nothing in me, he will have nothing in you. I said he will have nothing in you. So that's why, as you look at this prophetic word, when Jesus Christ himself came, now he spoke to his disciples in Luke chapter 10. Luke chapter 10. It says in verse 18, and he said unto them, that's Jesus Christ now, he said, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Hallelujah. Satan is falling before you. Satan is falling before us. Children of God, I said, Satan is falling before you. He's falling before us. He will not be able to stand in Jesus' name. And Jesus Christ said, as I see him falling, I don't want to leave you the way you are. I'm going to empower you so that it will continue to fall before you. It will not just fall once, it will fall continually. It will fall today. It will fall tomorrow. It will fall this week. It will fall next week. It will fall this month. It will fall next month. It will fall the month after. As you go into the new year, Satan will be falling before you in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the Lord. So Jesus said, I see Satan falling. Yes, right now he is falling. But listen, behold, look up. Your salvation is here. Look up. Power is here. Look up. Glory is here. Don't wait till the millennial reign to enjoy peace. Start enjoying the peace of the Lord right now. He says, I give peace that no man can give. I give joy that no man can give. He said, I give you peace and joy, and I give you light, and you become a light to your generation. He said, you become a city that is set upon a hill that cannot be hidden. That when you go out into the world, they can see the light of God shining upon you. They can see the light of the glory of Christ shining upon you. So he says, behold, look up, I give unto you power. Everybody say power. God has given you power, not weakness, not timidity. Listen, brethren, with all that has been happening around us for the past few months, it is possible for somebody to be so down and feeling like you cannot do anything. Let me tell you, you can do a lot. I said you can do a lot. Power has been given to you. Don't let the devil be showing you only the things going on out there. The problems, the challenges, you know, the corona problem, you know, people in the hospital, those who are dying and all of those things. The devil can show so much of that, that our soul is so weighed down. And we feel like we are powerless. No. He says, behold, I give unto you what? Power. And what is the power going to do? He said, the Satan that is already falling before you, you begin to tread over him. You begin to trample him. I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power. Not some of it. Not a few of it. All. Complete. Every power of the enemy will be falling before you, and you'll be trampling them over in Jesus' name. Amen. Over all the power of the enemy, and nothing, I believe that's for you. Amen. That is for me. And nothing shall by any means hurt me. I said, nothing shall by any means hurt me. I thought you'd make it yours. Nothing shall by any means hurt me. Nothing will hurt you. Not corona, not any other sickness, not corona, not cancer, not high blood pressure, not any other sickness, whatever name it is called, none of them will hurt you in Jesus' name. Why? Because the cross of Jesus cancels corona, cancels cancer, cancels diseases. Amen. So when you believe in that word, it is yours. I said it is yours. In the name of Jesus, he says, behold, I give unto you power. I said, I give unto you power. God has given you power. Say, God has given me power. And that power is to tread on serpents and scorpions and diseases and all the evil things that the enemy may be. And none of them shall be able to stand against me. None of them will be able to hurt you. They will not hurt you in Jesus' name. Brethren, listen, God is bigger than any trouble that may be in the world, than any problem that may be in the world. when the plagues started in Egypt, it was like the plagues are even more serious. Sometimes they can't even see God in the midst of it. The enemy will bring a whole lot of confusion. But listen, those of us who are going to escape through this, when we escape by the power of Christ, when we escape by the power of Jesus, when we escape by the shed blood of Christ, when we escape by the promises and the goodness of the Lord upon our lives. Amen. That's why Apostle Peter, as if taking the baton from Jesus Christ, he said in 2 Peter, in the epistle that goes by his name, 2 Peter chapter 1, 2 Peter chapter 1, 2 Peter chapter 1, look at it there with me. He says, Simon Peter, servants and apostle of Jesus Christ, to them that have obtained like precious faith. Hallelujah. He is speaking to you. I said he is speaking to you. He said if you have obtained like precious faith. He said the faith that we have. Because by grace are ye saved. Through what? Through faith. And that not of yourself. It is the gift of God. Not of works. Lest any man should boast. So we have this great gift, precious gift, that is given unto us. Salvation of our soul, redemption of our soul. Oh, you may be asking me, Pastor, I have not received that. Well, this is your day. I said today is your day. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day of believing Christ. Because I want to talk about the great things. The dominion, I call the message the dominion of believers in Christ. Amen. The dominion, we have dominion. We have authority. We have power over all the evil that the enemy is doing. We're not going to lie down and let the enemy walk over us. No, we are walking over him. We are treading him under our feet. In the name of Jesus. So, Apostle Paul said, this blessing I'm talking about is given to those who are saved. Those who have precious, precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. And then he says, grace and peace be unto you. Do you see that? Every time the apostles will talk to us, they always extend the blessing of the grace of God. The grace of God that bringeth salvation. They always extend that grace. And then they said, that grace brings peace. Amen. Amen. It's an experiential thing. When grace comes, it brings peace to your heart. You are not troubled. You are not troubled by things going around, things present, things to come, things that are down, things that are up, things that are good, things that are not. You are not bothered by any of that. You just have peace because grace of God just brings that joy into your heart. Apostle Paul says, I am bringing you peace through the grace of God. And I'm asking the peace to be multiplied. Amen. Maybe there's an aspect of your life you are not experiencing that peace. Apostle Peter said, let that peace multiply. Multiply in your heart. Maybe you only have peace concerning, your career, but your family, you don't have peace. Let the peace of God extend to your family. Maybe you are having peace and joy with regard, to your spiritual life, but other areas of your life, you are not enjoying peace. He said, let that peace extend to every area. You are not just going to have peace only spiritually. You are going to have peace even secularly, career-wise, every area, in your relationship, in your family. The peace of God that is upon you is going to move to every area of your life. It will be multiplied in Jesus' name. I said the peace will be multiplied upon you. The joy will be multiplied upon you. In the name of Jesus. So it says, grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and Jesus our Lord. And then he goes on to say, according as his divine power has given unto us all things. Amen. Power, all things. Grace, all things. Dominion, all things. In fact, as you think about dominion, dominion is the entire, when you have entire, total, and absolute control over circumstances around you. You have total control. And that control is the control that Jesus gives. It's the control that the grace of God gives. Nothing panics you. You are settled in your mind. You are not worried about the things happening around you. You just rest in God. You say, I have my life in the hand of God, and nothing can happen to me unless God permits it. And if God permits it, it is for my good. It is for his glory. It is to bring goodness to me. Amen. And so you are absolutely rested in the hands of God. So this message is important for all believers today to understand. Number one, we have divine power that has been given unto us. Apostle Peter said that. He said we have divine power in that verse 3. He says, according as his divine power has given us all things. All things. No perplexity. Understanding. Knowledge. Grace. Empowerment. Enrichment. All things. God has given it to you. See, the problem many a time is that we neglect what God has given and we are running after what we have not been given. If you can just enjoy what God has given, you will see how peaceful your life will be. The grace that God has given, if you can just enjoy, many a times, 95% of the time, what we have, we are not enjoying. We are only obsessing and concerned about what we don't have. Whatever you don't have, if it is the will of God, you will have them. I said you will have them. If it is the will of God. Because there are some things that look good to you. To God, it will not bring blessing. So God will delay it. God will remove it. God will hinder it. So that you don't have them. So that you can become who he wants you to be. Amen. But all that we need for life and godliness, the scripture says, he has given unto us all things that pertain unto life. That's the present life, the physical life, and also unto godliness. That's the spiritual, the eternal. Through the knowledge of him that called us to glory, that's Jesus, and virtue, whereby are given unto us. Look at it now. He says, number one, you have those divine power. Number two, you have great and precious promises. That's what spells our dominion. That's where our dominion is. You see the divine power that gives us all things. Number two, you see the great and precious promises that God has given unto us. Great and precious. Promises that are not available to the people of the world. We have it. We have the name of Jesus. We have the blood of Jesus. We have the grace of God. We can call on his name. We have answers to prayer. We can commune with God. We can talk about God. We have God as our Father. We have Jesus as our brother. We have other believers. People of like precious faith. We have the blessing of that fellowship. Great is our inheritance in God. Great is our blessings in God. So, Apostle Peter said, we have divine power. We have great and precious promises that God has given unto us. And that should rest our heart. That should make us understand that we are enriched, empowered, and strengthened. He said, whereby are given unto us, in verse 4, exceeding great and precious promises. And he says, that by this, because of all of that, he said, now you also become partakers. Partakers of what? Divine nature. Hallelujah. That's part of the blessing. That's part of the empowerment. You are partakers of the divine nature, and then he says, you escape corruption. Amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I escape corruption. He said, we have escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. Amen. All the things that people are lusting after, he said, we have escaped it. We have escaped. There are things that people will be running after, and if they don't have it, they want to kill themselves. We have escaped that. It's not wrong for us to enjoy the good things of life, but they don't drive us. Amen. They are not our drivers. It's not something that if I don't have it, then I must kill myself. God forbid. If God brings it, great. If God says no, great. We have escaped the lust. We don't lust after anything in the world. That is the power of God that is keeping us. That is the grace of God that is keeping us. And I pray we will never lose that grace.
Amen.
I say we will never lose that grace.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. And this spells our dominion. Our dominion in Christ is entire, total, and absolute control over every situation, every circumstance, even the oppression of the enemy. We are not bothered so much about it. We are not lifting the devil up so much that the devil feels like he's somebody. Jesus said, I see Satan fall down. And he said, behold, I give you power now to tread over him. He has fallen, you are treading over him, because God has lifted you and I to higher places in Christ Jesus. Amen. Higher places in Christ Jesus. And my prayer is that this day, the Lord of glory, by his power, by his grace, he will take us to those higher areas in Jesus' name. So as we have dominion, control over every device, operation, and activities of the devil, therefore, whatever satanic cohorts are doing, we don't allow it to make us to be afraid. Amen. We must never be afraid. Scripture says, God has not given us the spirit of fear. Fear is one of the strongest gifts that the devil gives people. You will not receive it.
Amen.
I will not receive it.
Amen.
We will not receive it.
Amen.
Fear is everywhere. Fear of virtually, you are even afraid of yourself. Sometimes you are afraid of yourself because the devil can really make you to be afraid of yourself. Everything around you wants to make you to be afraid. But the Bible says God has given you power to be above that. To not exercise your life on the basis of the fear that the enemy is propagating. Put your life in the promises of God. Put your life inside the divine nature. Put your life in the great and precious promises that has been given unto us. Put your life, you know, in all that the divine power that God has made available to you and to me. And the enemy will not be able to find us.
Amen.
Brethren, the devil may be flexing his muscle, but God is greater.
Oh, yes.
That's why I sang those songs. It's deliberate. Our God is greater. Our God is higher. Our God is mightier than every roaring sea, than every activity of the enemy. All that the devil is doing all over the world, God is still greater. All the activities of Satan that we are seeing everywhere, lives being lost, property being destroyed, economies being ruined, that's the devil. It's not God. It's the devil. Amen.
Amen.
And he will lose at the end.
Amen.
I said he will lose at the end.
Amen.
You know, they already read to us that a time is coming. You go and read Revelation 20, verse 1 to 3, part of the passages of this morning. God is going to bind him and throw him in the bottomless pit. He has no power. But because God is permitting him to act now, he is going as if he is God of the whole universe. He is not. I said he is not.
Amen.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. He's higher than every situation and circumstances around us. So there may be affliction, there may be oppression, there may be suppression, there may be depression. You know, the devil may be causing setbacks all around. There will be retrogression, failures in some areas of life, sickness, disease, bad luck, ill luck, mysterious happenings. God is greater than them all. Whatever name they are called, God is greater than them all. And if God is greater than them all, you are greater than them all. Because you are in God, and God is in you. Ye are of God, little children, and ye have overcome them. For greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Amen.
Amen.
Greater is he that is in the believers. Because from the beginning I told you, we are talking about the believer, the dominion of those who believe in Christ. We have dominion, and we must not be sissy. We must not be jelly-like, afraid of everything. People are afraid outside, you are afraid. It's like, if everybody is running, you are running. And people say, why are you running? I don't know, but everybody is running. What makes you a believer? You cannot just be running. You need to know why you are running and where you are running to. And the Lord's grace will be multiplied upon you and I in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's look at three things quickly, as our manner is. Three things. Number one, power to conquer devil's devices has been given to you. Power to do what? To conquer devil's devices. God has given it to you. If the power is not working, you need to do something to make it work. Praise God. Bible says, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. let your request be made known unto God. And then he says, when you do it well, and then he says, the peace of God that passes all understanding will flood your heart. That's what we are looking for. We want to have peace, abundant peace, grace and peace, as Peter said, multiply. If you want that multiplication of the grace and the blessing of God, then commit yourself to prayer. Commit yourself to the service of God. Commit yourself to loving God like never before. And see how God will be lavishing his love upon you, giving his grace more unto you, multiplying his power in your life. So we are going to talk about the power to conquer devil's devices. Number two, we are going to talk about prevailing and conquering devil's devices. We are going to prevail and conquer his devices. I said we will prevail and conquer his devices. And then finally, we'll talk about perpetual dominion. So this dominion is not something that is just for a moment. All through your lifetime, you will dominate the enemy. All through your lifetime, you will conquer the enemy. Perpetual dominion over devil's devices. Perpetual dominion over devil's devices. So shall it be. I said, so shall it be. You see, everyone needs the power of God. Everyone needs the power. That's the power I'm talking, the power to conquer devil's devices. Everyone needs that power. And everyone that surrender to the Lordship of Christ, Jesus Christ said in that passage that we read in the book of Luke chapter 10, he says, behold, Luke chapter 10 verse 19, Luke 10, verse 19. Let me get there quickly. Are you there with me? Verse 19. Behold, I give unto you power. Now, who was Jesus talking to here? He was talking to the 70 that he sent out. It wasn't to everybody. So the power of God is not to everybody in the world. The only power that is for everyone in the world that is incontrovertible is the power of salvation. That's why Paul apostle said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto what? Unto salvation to everyone that believe. Everyone that come to believe in Christ, then the power is given to them. So I'm talking this morning about that power to conquer devil's devices. And Jesus said, for the 70 that came to me, that surrendered to me, that followed me, and I sent them out, I have given them the power. Amen. Amen. The power is given to you.
Amen.
As a child of God, you have the power.
Amen.
I said you have the power, and the power will go along with you.
Amen.
And the power will do well in your life.
Amen.
And the power will do something wonderful in your life in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So he says, behold, I give unto you power. So if somebody doesn't have that power, then there is need to run after it. The disciples who follow Christ said, I give unto you power. When they were living in Mark chapter 16, when he was living, he said in verse 15, and he said unto them, this is to the disciples, his children, the ones that followed him, verse 14, afterward he appeared unto the 11 as they sat at meat and upbraided them for their unbelief and hardness of heart. He said, you need to believe in this power. This power is available to you. This power is meant for you. Do something to make sure you are walking in power. Don't walk in weakness. Don't think and meditate on weakness. Too many people are meditating on weaknesses like, this will consume, this will happen, that will happen. I say, God forbid. I say, God forbid, evil will not be your lot in Jesus' name. He said unto them, to all these people who are gathered with them, he upbraided them for their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they believed not that we shall see him after he was risen. He had told them all of those things that will happen. They didn't believe. Jesus has prophesied about the days that we are in. And now that you and I are seeing him, he says there will be perilous times that will come. Not just people becoming lovers of themselves, but there will be pandemics and troubles and trials and problems everywhere. But they that believe and trust in the Lord, they shall be saved.
Amen.
They will be saved spiritually.
Amen.
they will be saved from the pandemic. They will be saved from the trouble that is coming. And I'm talking about you. I'm talking about me. I am saved from the pandemic. I am saved from the problems of the world. I am saved. I am kept secure. You are kept secure in Jesus' name. So this power is great. And God wants you and I to make sure we remain on the side of the Lord. Look at what he said. He said unto them in verse 15, Mark 16, 15. Go ye into all the world. He knew there would be pandemic there. He said, go into it. He knew there would be problem there. He said, go into it. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. It's not a time for us to keep quiet. This is the means by which the power of God will come upon us. Unrestrained. This is the time that God wants to demonstrate his power. Go ye into the world. Go out. As we're going out, use every medium possible, you know, to reach out to people with the gospel of Christ. He says, go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And then he goes on to say, since I know you will believe. I said, I know you will believe.
Amen.
I know you believe.
Amen.
I know you will continue to believe.
Amen.
Now, here is the word of God to you, like the apostle of those days. He says, and these signs shall follow you.
Amen.
If you are like in my own Bible, I've changed all of those things. My name is already there. I wrote my name there. These signs shall follow Adeniyi.
Amen.
I said, shall follow Adeniyi. In his name, he said, in my name. And I said, in the name of Jesus, I shall cast out devils. And then he shall speak with new tongues. He shall take up serpents. If he drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt me. I will lay my hands on the sick, and they will recover. I will lay my hands on the sick, and they will recover. Say that about yourself. I will lay my hand on the sick. I will pray for the sick. I will speak to those who are sick, and they will recover. That's the power that God has given unto you. The Bible says, and so then after the Lord has spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God. But look at it now. Verse 20, and they went forth. Obedience. That's what activates the power. What activates the power? Obedience. Obedience. Disobedience does not activate God's power. Fear does not allow God's power to work. Oh, if I talk to them, maybe they will not. Who cares? Just speak. That's okay. If I do this, maybe don't think about it. Just do it. Obey him who has called you. The disciples here, they saw what the Lord said. They went forth and preached everywhere. The Lord walking with them. From today, as you begin to obey God, God will be walking with you.
Yeah.
He'll be walking around you. He'll be walking inside you. He'll be working for you in the name of Jesus. Say, the Lord will be working with me. The Lord is working for me. He is working around me in the name of Jesus. They went forth. I will go forth. I will go forth this morning. I will preach everywhere I find myself. And the Lord will work with me, confirming the word with signs following. Praise the Lord. You know, when the obedience is complete, you see God working. Obedience. Obedience. It does a lot to bring the power of God. The church today, I don't mean the church here, I said the church universal, is weak because there's lack of obedience. The church in America is weak because truth has been muddled and modified. And when we allow the truth of the gospel to come, people don't preach the gospel in truth. They want some people to keep following them. So they see things in the life of those people, they don't want to talk about it. Give them the truth. Let the power of God set them free. Let the grace of God be multiplied. Let the peace of God be multiplied. So he says, they went forth. We are going forth.
Amen.
From today, we are going forth. In obedience to Christ, we are going forth. I said we are going for. You know, John was one of them who was here when Christ was talking. And look at what he says in 1 John. 1 John chapter 1. He says, if you want the power to work, You are not going to be walking in darkness and be expecting the power to walk. You are not going to be walking contrary to Christ and expect the power to walk. It will not work. 1 John, 1 Epistle of John, chapter 1, verse 6 to 10. Let me start from verse 5. It says, this is the message which we have heard of him, and declare unto you that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him, we are following him, we are doing it, and we walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. But if we walk in the light, hallelujah. I said hallelujah. If we walk in what? In the light, because he is light. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. Look at it now. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanseth us from what? From some sins, from some situations. Oh, no exception. His blood cleanses us from every situation. But if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. That is, you know, you are coming and say, all this issue of them talking about sin, 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 I don't have any. You are deceiving yourself. Thank God, I believe those of us who are hearing me this morning, either here in the church or there in your house or online, I am trusting God that you have walked out of darkness, you are coming to the light of Christ. And I pray you continue to walk in that light in Jesus' name. You have abandoned the work of the devil. You have run away from whatever it is that the devil is making people to do in the world. You have set yourself apart for Christ, for God, and you are now walking in the light. Then the power of God can work with you. Then the light of God can work in you. May that be your portion and your possession in Jesus' name. So he says, if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sin, isn't that wonderful? Confession. Confession. Sometimes you confess even some of your weak area, the things you are not doing, and you tell God, Lord, look at this area. Things are not right there. It's part of, even you are a child of God, say, Lord, this area, the strength and the power that I need, I'm not seeing it. And, you know, your apostle says, grace and peace be multiplied. Power of God be multiplied. Father, multiply your grace and power in this area. The Lord will answer you. Yeah. I said, God will answer you. Yeah. In Jesus' name. If we confess our sins, if we confess our weakness, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. We confess those sins as what they are. We don't minimize them. We don't call them something else. It is sin. The Bible calls it sin. You call it sin. It says to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. God says it will cleanse you. Amen. I said God says it will cleanse you. Amen. And I pray it will cleanse you and I. Amen. I said God will cleanse you and I. Amen. In the name of Jesus. You know, look at the book of Psalm 51. It talks about confessing, confessing, confessing. May God give you grace to do so. Amen. I said, may God give you grace. Amen. To do so in Jesus' name. Give your Bible to Psalm, the book of Psalm. Psalm 51. Psalm 51. I'm reading verse 16 and 17. Psalm 51. It talks about the power of God. Power of God. May God empower you today. Amen. I said, may God empower you today. He said, for thou desirest not sacrifice, else will I give it. Thou delightest not in burnt offering. Look at verse 17. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart, O God, thou will not despise. If we have a contrite spirit, and that contrite spirit, brethren, is not even just for the sinners only, but even for the believers who feels weak, who feels that it's not accomplishing the purpose of God, and you have that kind of contrition, the Lord will visit you. Amen. His power will be released unto you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Because this power is needed to do something wonderful, marvelous, in your life, and God will do it for you. Amen. I said, God will do it for you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. The book of John. John chapter 1. John chapter 1. It tells us that the power is available when we do what is right. Power to conquer devil's devices. John chapter 1. John chapter 1. In verse 12, but as many as received him. Are they here this morning?
Yeah.
As many as have you received him?
Yeah.
Are you there online? Are you there at home? Are you there here in front of me? As many as received him. What did he give to you?
Yeah.
I said, what did he give to you?
Yeah.
Not weakness. Not fear of the devil. Not fear of everything that come around. Power. May power be yours today. May that power be multiplied to you. As many as received him, to them, not just to him only, but to them, as many as they may be, thousands in a day, hundreds in a day, two a day, wherever they are, as many as received him, to them gave he power. Power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Born of God, power will be given you.
Amen.
I said power will be given you. And that it will not be somebody who says, I've received Christ, but they are still not walking in accordance to what Christ has given. You know, you and I will make sure that we are walking according to the will and the commands of God. We are walking in his grace. We are walking in his power. We are walking by the Spirit of God. And by the grace of God, the power will work in your life.
Amen.
I said the power of God will work in your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So, brethren, see yourself as Christ sees you. When he saw his disciple, he said, behold, I give unto you power. If you are his disciple, power is given to you.
Amen.
Authority is given to you.
Amen.
Anointing is given to you. So, see yourself the way God sees you. God sees the sinner as the enemy of the cross. And he says they must be reconciled before they can enjoy the power of God. But God sees the saint, the child of God. He says the righteous one is as bold as a lion. Proverbs 28 verse 1b. He says you will be bold because power has been given to you. So see yourself the way Christ sees you. How did he see you? He sees you as a conqueror. He sees you as somebody who has overcome. Hallelujah. He sees you as somebody who is special, who is different. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Look at how Christ sees you. Look at how the Word of God sees you. 2 Corinthians chapter 6. It says, and what agreement has the temple of God? He's talking about you. For ye are the temple of the living God. That's how he sees you. See yourself as so. When you can see yourself the way God sees you, his power can rest on you. His power can work in you. His power can work with you. And it will work with you.
Amen.
It will work for you. It will work in you. It will work around you. See yourself. Don't see yourself as being cast out. You know, I'm not worthy of anything. No, you are. You are. God has raised you up. If you are saved, you are a child of God, you are raised up, you know, to high places with Christ Jesus. See yourself as heaven sees you. Don't minimize the work of the cross. Don't minimize the grace of Christ in your life. Make sure you activate the power of God in your life by being obedient to the word of God, and the power of God will work for you.
Amen.
I said the power of God will work for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. So it says in that passage, ye are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in you. Look at that. And walk in them. And I will be their God. And they shall be my people. Hallelujah. They shall be. That's how God sees you. Don't be like an outcast in the kingdom. Don't be like an outcast. Be bold. Be courageous. And accept what God has done in your life. And the Bible says in Romans chapter 8, you know, God says he's working with you, he's working in you, he's doing everything for you. Romans chapter 8, look at what the Bible says. Romans 8, verse 31. Romans 8, 31. What shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Brethren, God says he is for you. Do you believe that? Do you accept that? Nothing can be against you. I said nothing will be against you. If they go against you, they go against their life. If they go against you, they go against their very existence. If they go against you, they go against God, and everything that goes against God, they rock, it will break. If God goes against them, they will be crushed. So, if God be for us, who can be against us? Nothing will be against you. Take your stand in the Lord. Say, I have power in Christ. I have authority in Christ. The name of Jesus works for me. The name of Jesus works in me. The name of Jesus works around me. It will continue to work for you. It will continue to work around you. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. I said, so shall it be. For the Bible says that you are an ambassador of Christ. Amen. 2 Corinthians 5. He says you are what? Ambassador. I mean, what does an ambassador do? Ambassador represents the nation where he came from. But listen, you cannot be an ambassador for a nation if you are not a citizen of that nation. Have you ever realized that? That's why even when a nation will make somebody who is in another country to be the ambassador, they first nationalize him. They give him citizenship. It may be honorary or whatever name you call it. It may be by a decree or by the signature of the president or whatever law is available. They'll make the individual their citizen so that he can represent it. That's why you see many of the fellows who end up working in some of the embassies at the end of the day, that's why they're able to travel to those countries where they are representing. Even when you are in a nation and you are working in the embassy there, they already count you as a citizen of that nation where you are working for. And you know you can travel there easily and come back easily. You are a citizen. So when the Bible says you are an ambassador for Christ, it already means you are a citizen of heaven. Amen. I said you are already a citizen of heaven. Amen. Authority of heaven is backing you. Power of heaven is behind you. What will make you to be afraid? Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. And his power will work for you. Amen. I said his power will work for you. You know, you are not like Simon the sorcerer. You are neither in or out. You are not like Demas, you know, who was with Paul and then later on he ran. You are not like Judas. You know, you serve God for, you know, just think about Judas. 3.5 years of working with Jesus didn't do much in his life. He still was filled with his old self. Praise God. He still was filled with his old self. So if you say you are for God, be totally separated and give it to God. The power will work in you. Mm-hmm. You see, when you keep on looking back, I'm not sure if I'm a child of God. I'm not sure if I want to be a Christian. I'm not sure if I want to remain. I'm not every day, I'm not sure. You will not be sure. I'm just telling you, you will not. But there has to be a conviction to say, here I stand. You know, like Paul, he said, what shall separate us? He said, what? What is it? What is going to separate us? He said, not even death, not life. He said, there's nothing in this life. There's nothing I'm enjoying in this life that can hinder me, that can separate me. He said, there's no fear of death. There's no height. There's no depth. Nothing greater. Something that is still, even things I've never known. Something that is come, something that is past, something that is present. None of them. Is it imprisonment? Is it perdition? Is it error? Is it lies of the enemy? Is it affliction? Whatever it is, say nothing. That man's mind was made up. I pray your mind will be made up. Amen. I said, I pray your mind will be made up. Amen. That God is God and there is none else, and God will work for you. Amen. I said, God will work for you. When God tries your faith, may you not fail. Amen. I said, when God tries your faith, may you not fail. Amen. Because he says a time is coming that I'm going to separate between the clean and the unclean. I'm going to know those who are following me and those who are not following me. I'm going to test them. When you are tested, may you stand secure. Amen. May you stand faithful. Amen. To the end in the name of Jesus. Number two now, prevailing. Prevailing, that is authority. Conquering, prevailing and conquering devil's devices. Prevailing and conquering devil's devices. You will conquer. Amen. Listen, brethren, that God gave you power is good, but that's not just the best. The best is that you are able to use that power and you turn it to authority. You can exert authority. Every believer is given power. Amen?
Amen?
Automatically, he has given you power. So don't doubt that, but convert that power to what? Authority. You know, it's like a president. After he's elected, he has the power. And then the inauguration comes in, he receives authority. Now, if listen, the president can do and undo. I'm telling you, he will do some funny stuff, you wouldn't even believe it. But he's immune. Amen? That should tell you something. You are immune to the tactics of the devil. You are immune when the authority of Christ rests in you. You are immune. Whatever the devil is trying to do, he cannot succeed. So convert that power to authority so that you dominate and rule wherever you are. That's what I'm talking about in this second part. Prevailing and conquering devils. The devil will try all kinds of tricks. That's his life. That's his nature. He will not stop until the end of the world. But it is your right, by the power given to you, to dominate him, to dominate your environment, to make sure there is no crack by which he can come in. Praise the Lord. That's what we are talking about. So be ready to use the authority that God gave you, and you will use it.
Amen.
I say you will use it. Luke 10, 19, again, behold, I give unto you what? Power. Power. That power will be yours.
Amen.
Colossians chapter 2. Colossians chapter 2. Prevailing and conquering devil's devices. Prevailing and conquering devil's devices. You know, the devices of the devil is to be telling you how you are weak. How you cannot do it. And he will say it for 1,000 times until you begin to believe it. That's the most unfortunate. You see, devil doesn't get tired of discouraging people. He won't discourage you now and you say, no, devil, get away. Well, you may be able to chase him away. Be sure he's coming back. So the issue here is you take your stand. You say, here I stand. And that's it. Here is my conviction. Devil, you can bring a wind. You can bring anything. I'm standing on this conviction. Your conviction, your anchor must hold in Christ. You must not be wavering. Maybe not. The way you are moving up and down like this, the enemy will move you, but you stand. You will stand.
Amen.
I say you will stand.
Amen.
But the devices of the enemy is to bring discouragement, to say all sorts of things. Look at Colossians chapter 2. It says, buried with him in baptism, verse 12, wherein also ye are risen with him, through the faith of the operation of God, who has raised him from the dead. Listen, think about Jesus Christ as an example. All the way from the beginning, the devil tried to make him abandon the cross. Before the ministry started, he tested him, he tried him. He said, I will give this to you, I will do that to you, I will take him all. You know, if you just bow to me, if you just do a little thing. And that tactic is still there. It's not, the devil has not been. You see, Jesus overcame. The same trial that he went through, the same lies of the devil, you will go through it. But you will overcome.
Amen.
Because Jesus already overcame for you.
Amen.
You must overcome. The devil will not stop lying. You see, when the devil tried them physically by himself and he could not succeed, then he began to borrow the hearts of some people. Scribes and Pharisees, they call them. You know, unbelievers out there, they call them. And then they begin to call question. Let's ask him question. Let's make him fall. Let's do this. Those are tactics of the devil. It will not stop, but you stand where you stand. I love the word of Job in Job 17, verse 7. He said, the righteous also shall hold on to his ways. You hold on. Job 17, verse 7. Let's read that. I just paraphrased, but I'd like to read it. I'll come back to that Colossians 2. You can just put a paper there. We'll come back. But Look at what Job said. This was why Job prevailed, and this is why you will prevail.
Amen.
I said you will prevail.
Amen.
Job chapter 17, verse 9. The righteous also shall do what? Shall hold on his way. He that has clean hands shall be what? Stronger and stronger. You will never be weak.
Amen.
Is it possible to be stronger and stronger? Absolutely. The Bible says, when you are strong, you become stronger and become the strongest, and you keep moving on. You are not looking back. Praise the Lord. God is not interested in a believer who has been strong becoming weak and becoming a ping pong in the hand of the devil. No. He wants you to become stronger and stronger. You'll be stronger than your enemies.
Amen.
If there are thousands, they come, they meet you stronger than them.
Amen.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Look at how many armies must against Elisha, and the servant was, oh my master, what are we going to do? He said, we have to do nothing, because they that are for us are greater and more than they that are against us. Don't look at those who are against you. Don't look at the forces, the difficulties you have to face. Look at the God that is behind you. Amen.
Amen.
You know, in the physical realm, you think about it, somebody wants to beat a little child, you know, in our younger days. All you need to do is run behind your father. You know, I say, Daddy, somebody wants to beat me. Would that person be able to beat you where, Daddy? No. And many a times we'll be taunting him. We just put our hands in. You know, they can't do anything. Even though we are taunting them, they can't do anything. Daddy is there. Daddy is with you.
Amen.
Your father in heaven is with you.
Amen.
Ah, with Jesus in your boat, you can laugh at the storm.
Amen.
Simon Peter laughed at the storm. The apostles and the disciples of Christ, they laugh at the storm. The storm didn't consume them. You will not be consumed.
Amen.
You will prevail over every storm of the moment. The one that has come, the one that is prevailing now, the one that will come, you will overcome in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Stand strong in Christ. The righteous also shall hold on to his way. And he that has clean hands, he shall be what? I shall be what? You shall be what? Stronger and stronger. And so, it tells us in that Colossians 2 that we are reading, in verse 13, and you being dead in your sins and uncircumcision of the flesh, has he quickened. Hallelujah. You are quickened. Bible says, Christ is the judge of the quick and the dead. You are quickened. What does it mean to be quickened? You are made alive. You are made alive. Your dead body is made alive. Like the body of those dead bones in the valley in Ezekiel 37, he said, God breathed on you and brought you alive. Amen. Brought you alive. You are no longer dead. You are alive. Say, I'm alive.
I'm alive.
Do you believe it?
Yes.
Say it again. I'm alive.
I'm alive.
Do you believe it?
Yes.
Say it one more time. I'm alive.
I'm alive.
Alive in Christ.
Alive in God.
Alive in God.
Alive in God.
The enemy cannot overcome me. Praise God. You who are dead, he has quickened together with him. Not just with somebody else, with him. As Jesus was quickened to die no more, you are quickened and death will have no power over you.
Amen.
Quickened. He says, ye who are dead, he has quickened together with him, having forgiven all trespasses. He has forgiven you. All, that's why the power works when trespasses are not there, when sin is not there, when guilt is not there, when you are not, you know, when you are not unstable, you know, like Jacob said to one of his sons, unstable, he said, Reuben, thou art my first son, unstable as water, thou shalt not excel. When someone is unstable, they cannot excel. Instability here and there. A believer must be known for something and he must stand there. Stand there. You ask Jesus a question yesterday, he will give you an answer. Tomorrow, he will give you the same answer. Every day, you wake him up, he will give you the same answer. And the believer must be like that. Your answer must always be yes or no, depending on the situation, as the Spirit of God will lead you. Say, you, he has quickened. And as he has quickened you and forgiven your sins, verse 14, blotting out the handwriting of the ordinances that was against us, which was contrary, whatever the enemy has written concerning you is blotted out.
Amen.
All the past stories of this is blotted. You have to believe it. If you are not believing it and you are saying, I know they are still there, it means you are the one who opened the door. A door that God has shut, you cannot open it. Don't keep the door open to the devil. Tell the devil this door is shut, it's never to be opened.
Amen.
A door of sickness is shut, it will not be opened.
Amen.
A door of instability is shut, it will not be opened.
Amen.
The door of backsliding is shut, it will not be opened.
Amen.
The door of looking back, like Lot's wife, is shut, we will not look back.
Amen.
We are moving forward.
Amen.
Stronger and stronger.
Amen.
Higher and higher. Greater and greater, up and up, forward ever, backward never, so shall it be for you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. That's how you prevail. That's how, it's not just prevailing and having power for once. You want to have the power continually. You want to translate that power to authority. You want to dominate everything. Things that usually mess other people off, sees you and says, I can't, don't touch this. Don't touch that man. You can't do anything about him. May that be your life.
Amen.
May that be our life.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we are prevailing. We are prevailing. This means, number one, you have absolute faith in the omnipotence of God.
Hallelujah.
Absolute faith. There's no doubt.
Amen.
It doesn't matter what the devil brings. No doubt. Yes. God is supreme.
Amen.
God is awesome. God is greater. Whatever he allows, whatever he permits, there's a reason. And that thing will not take my life. Let it be there. I will overcome it.
Mm-hmm.
And you will overcome.
Mm-hmm.
Absolute, complete faith in Christ. You are not faithless. Hebrews 11 says, you remember that passage? But without faith, it is impossible. It is only impossible for them that has no faith. For a child of God, nothing is ever impossible.
Amen.
Nothing that God cannot do for you. He said, he that freely gave his son to you, how is it that he will not also freely give you all things? He has given his son to you. That's the greatest possession that God could have. What else can a man have than his children? Property you cannot count property, house, car, and all of that. You cannot equate them to your children. Praise God. You can have the whole world, no child, you will feel miserable. But you can't have a child or several children, you don't have money. You say, well, God will take care of us. God will make a way. You'll be happy. You'll be glad. So God gave his only son. Gave it all for you. If he gave that, there's nothing else he cannot give. And there's nothing good that he will take from you. In the name of Jesus. So number one, absolute faith. Number two, you have to apply the promises of God at all times. Don't apply it one time and stop. No, keep applying it. Three times, the devil tested Christ, and he kept saying, it is written, it is written, it is written. If there was fourth temptation, I am sure Jesus would have said, it is written. So in your case, when the devil brings temptation, trial, problem, keep on saying what? What's your answer to the devil?
It is written.
It is written that greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. It is written that whosoever calleth on the name of the Lord shall be saved. It is written that by his stripes I am healed. It is written that God will bless my water. I will bless my bread. And will not allow disease of the Egyptians upon me. It is written that I will overcome them because greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. It is written, you keep on quoting the word of God at all times, to all situations. I and the children that the Lord has given me, we are for signs and wonders in America. It is written, you keep on quoting the word of God, promises of God in all circumstances. And his promises are more than enough to cover all your challenges. And we do so in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number three, the efficacy of prayer. Efficacy of prayer. Keep on praying. Keep on praying. Keep on praying. Keep on praying. Don't give up. Keep on praying. Keep on praying. Keep on praying. Never give up. Pray in the morning. Pray at night. Pray during the day. You know, it may be short prayer, 5 minutes. Maybe one. Maybe a muttering prayer, 1 minute, whatever it is. God brings something to your heart. you mutter, you say, oh God, please help me. If that's all you say, that's prayer. You know, don't say prayer is too small. No, it's never too small. Don't say prayer is too long. It's never too long. You pray all day, that's great. You pray all week, all night, you know, all year, that's great. But if you pray for a minute, that's good also. Never stop. Just keep on praying. Praying, praying. Absolute faith in Christ, number two. The promises of God, number three. Effectual, fervent prayer. You continue in the name of Jesus. Number four, don't run from your challenges. It's only the one that is running that the devil will be pursuing. The Bible says, resist the devil. He will do what? He will flee. You have to resist. Don't keep running every time. I'm going to run. I'm going to run. No, don't run. That's how you are going to persevere in the things of God. Don't run from your challenges. Confront him with a persistent, persevering spirit. Confront the devil. Let him know that you know, your place in Christ. Number five, recall those past testimonies. Amen. There are things God has done for you before. The challenge may be greater. Like a Goliath before Israel. And a small David king. Is it that Goliath? King Saul, let me tell you something. There was a time in the forest, a bear came to take one of the sheep. Listen, brethren, I don't know if you have ever thought about that scenario. A bear came, and David didn't go and hide. A 17-year-old, 18-year-old, 18-year-old, he didn't go to hide and say, you know what, out of these many sheep, let him just take one and go away. No, one sheep was important for David to fight the bear. And he says, I fought him, I defeated him. Your testimony. Because if you don't resist the devil, you never have testimony. It is when you resist and fight, then you say, oh, he came last time, I defeated him, now I'm going to defeat him again. David said, a bear came, a lion came, I defeated him. He said, this uncircumcised Philistine is going to be like one of them. I said, this one, you know, the hand of God is not on him. There is no permission of God upon him. And then he's going to now insult the people of God, the circumcised people of God. He said, impossible. God forbid. He said, let me go and fight him. You know, it looks very stupid. It looks very foolish to any human mind, human eyes, to ask a 17-year-old to go and fight the tallest man in the whole world. But the man said, we are not talking about his height. We are talking about the height of God. The one who sits in heaven. And the earth is his footstool.
Amen.
So, how tall can Goliath be? When our God sits in heaven and his feet and the earth is just what? Footstool. So, he said, we are thinking about God. We are not thinking about the devil. Past testimonies. And brethren, number six, believe God. What did I say?
Believe God.
Paul Apostle says, I believe God that it shall be. As it has been told me. He said, God told me, the book of Acts, God told me that nobody will be lost in this ship. He said, but then I believe God, it shall be so. Believe God and believe his promises. Hallelujah. And our theme for this year is still there. Believe in the Lord, thou shalt be established.
Amen.
Believe in his prophet, thou shalt prosper. That will be your portion this year.
Amen.
It shall be your portion this year. Amen. Believe God. Rehearse and meditate on the faithfulness over the ages. Faithfulness of God. He has been faithful. He was faithful to Abraham, to Isaac, to Jacob, to Israel. He was faithful to them in the wilderness. 40 years they were there. They ate, they fed. None of them was lost except those who didn't obey him. It's only the unbelievers that perish. They are the ones who don't obey that God is not able to. You know, God says, go this way. They say, no, I'm not going that way. Go this way, I'm not going. Go and fight. They say, I can't fight. Go and move. They say, it's so that's the only people that miss the way. But if you allow God to guide you, he will guide you right. He will lead you right. You will not be lost. Rehearse and meditate on the faithfulness of God for all the ages, and all shall be well with you. I say, all shall be well with you. Finally, perpetual dominion. Point three, perpetual dominion. Over devil's devices. Perpetual, 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 continual dominion over the enemy. Amen. Amen. The anointing is already given. The power is already given. Look at what the Lord told Joshua. Let me read it. I may not be able to read too many, but we read one or two and then we go to the Lord in prayer. Perpetual, perpetual dominion, that's going to be yours. I said that's going to be yours. Joshua chapter 1. I'm reading from verse 3. Joshua. Joshua 1, verse 3. This is the word of God to Joshua and to the Israelites. It's the same word I'm transferring to you today. Amen. It will work for them, it will work for you.
Amen.
I said it will work for them, it will work for you.
Amen.
Verse 3, every place. See every place.
Every place.
That the sole
of my feet
shall tread upon this year.
In the coming year,
God has given it to me.
As
he said to Moses, from the wilderness unto Lebanon, and the great river, the river Euphrates, all the lands of the Hittites, all the lands of America, all over Minnesota, the Lord has given unto us. He says, and unto the great sea, towards the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. There shall not any man, I can't hear you, there shall not any man be able to stand before you all the days of thy life. As he was with Moses, the Lord will be with you. He will not fail you. He will not forsake you. Be strong and of a good courage. Be strong and of a good courage. And I pray God will make you strong. God will give you courage. You will not give up. I say you will not give up. The strength of God will abide with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Colossians chapter 2 that we read before. I'm going back there again before we pray. Remember, perpetual dominion. How do you get that? Number one, examine your life daily to ensure that you are complying with the will of God in every area. Examine your life. There are many people who say, it doesn't matter. You can live anyhow. No, you can't live anyhow. Don't mind those people. Don't live your life like the people of the world. You have been quickened. You understand. Examine your life daily. Number two, read and meditate on the word of God. Read and meditate on the word of God and his promises every day. Examine your life daily. Read and meditate on the word of God every day. And then possess the habit of relying on God. Rely on God and his power. Rely on God and his power. I like that song that we sing. Sing when your trials are greatest. The Bible says you must, allow the word of God and the will of God to become, the centrality of your life. Rely on God, rely on his power. Live in the consciousness of Christ's victory. He already has the victory. He already won the victory. The victory is yours. I said the victory is yours. Remember again, as I said, the source of power is prayer. Prayer is power. Prayer is power. That power will not fail you.
Amen.
Avoid pride and self-glorification. Now, many a times, all people talk about is just what I did, what I achieved. What... Talk about God. Talk about his word. Talk about his will. Let that be, your preoccupation. Never stop winning souls. Never stop soul winning. What did I say?
Never stop
winning souls. And as you continue, the power of God will continue with you. Because remember, it says, these signs shall follow them that believe. Do you believe? I said, do you believe? I said, do you believe? So shall it be for you. So shall it be with you. In Jeremiah, before we pray, Jeremiah. Jeremiah chapter 1. Jeremiah chapter 1. Rise up with me as we pray. Jeremiah chapter 1. The Lord says in verse 5, before I formed thee in the belly, I know thee. Before thou camest out of the womb, I sanctified thee. And I ordained thee as a prophet unto the nation. And then the Lord says, behold, in verse 9, He said, then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto him, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth. See, I have this day, September the 6th, this day, the Lord has set thee over this nation, over this kingdom. What needs to be rooted out, you will root out. What needs to be pulled down, the power is in your hand. What needs to be destroyed, the Lord has given you the power. What needs to be thrown down, he has been giving you the power. And then after that, you will have power to build. You have power to plant. You have power to raise up. May that power be yours today. As you go out, whatever needs to be pulled down, may they go down before you. As you go out, whatever needs to be rooted, may it be rooted before you. As you go out, what needs to be destroyed, may God destroy them. May God throw them down. And may God begin to build new things through you. May God begin to plant something in your life. And plant something through you in the name of Jesus. Do you receive that? Do you receive that? Open your mouth and bless the name of the Lord. Open your mouth and bless the name of the Lord. Give him praise. Give him praise. Glorify the Lord. Glorify the Lord. Magnify him. Magnify him. Worship him and give him praise. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you honor. We glorify you. We magnify you. Be thou exalted, O Lord. Be thou exalted, O Lord. Thank you, Father, for the power and the authority you are giving unto us. And Father, we are going to use that power and authority. Father, the victory and dominion of the believer. Lord Almighty, we are bound in dominion. We are bound in victory. All the days of our life, the enemy will not be able, O Lord, Father, to take away the blessing of God from our life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. You said you will have mercy. You will have mercy upon us. Father, we thank you for your mercy. Because you have chosen us. You have chosen us. And you have set us in this land. Oh, Lord, Father, we bless you. We glorify you. Blessed be thy holy name. Thank you to God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. You said it shall come to pass. It shall come to pass that the Lord will give us rest. The Lord will give us rest. The Lord will give you rest. Hallelujah. From sorrow. The Lord will give you rest from fear. The Lord will give you rest from heart bondage. In the mighty name of Jesus. Glory be to the name of the Lord. The Lord says he has broken the staff of the wicked. The Lord said the scepter of the ruler is broken in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Bible says the whole earth is at rest and is quiet. Hallelujah. They break forth into singing. Hallelujah. Your family will break forth into singing. Hallelujah. Our church will break forth into singing. We will be at rest. There will be quietness in our house. In the name of Jesus. He said the fir tree will rejoice when they see us. The cedars of Lebanon will rejoice when they see us. He says because we are loved of God. Oh, Father, we worship you. He said there will be no fella that will come against us. As trees in Lebanon, no fella, no one, no wicked one want to bring you down. In the name of Jesus, those who fall trees and bring them down, hallelujah. As a tree in the house of God, the enemy cannot bring you down. Believe that. Trust God for that. You will remain standing. You will remain standing. You will remain solid in the house of God. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Tell the Lord, tell the Lord, tell the Lord. Hallelujah, Father, we worship you. Father, we worship you. All the wills of Satan, all the will and desire of Satan, it will not come to pass. Father, you said in your word, I will break the Assyrian in my land. Upon my mountains, I will tread him under the foot. Hallelujah. So as I have talked, I shall come to pass. As I purpose, it shall stand. Lord, let your purpose and your plan come to pass in our life. In the name of Jesus, that by your invisible hand, by your invisible power, you will keep us. You will keep us in peace. Our hearts are stayed on you. You will keep us in perfect peace. So shall it be. So shall it be. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus. The Lord of hosts has purpose. Who shall disannul it? Father, all your purpose for our life. The enemy will not disannul. In the name of Jesus. The enemy will not cancel the purpose and plan of God for our life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, glorious God. Lord, we remain. We remain, O Lord, your promises. We remain standing on your promises, on the promises of God. We have absolute faith, absolute confidence in the word of God, in the name of Jesus. And Father, by your grace and power, let your spirit begin to work in us, work for us, work around us. Give us conviction to know that you will never fail. You can never fail. And so we cannot fail. We will not fail. In the name of Jesus, make sure you are reading and meditating on the word of God. Make sure you are relying on God. Keep the consciousness of the victory that Christ has won for you. Make sure that you are holding on to that victory, because that foreshadows your victory. That is pointing to your own victory. You are victorious because Christ was victorious. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Your source of power. Remember that source of power. Prayer. Pray during the day, at night, everywhere, whatever is going on, irrespective of the challenges. Pray all the time, and the grace of God, and the presence of God, and the power of God will be all over you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you glory. We adore you, we glorify you. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Isaiah 23, in verse 11. Isaiah 23, let me read verse 11. There the word of God says, he stretched out his hand over the sea. He shook the kingdoms. The Lord has given a commandment against the merchant city to destroy the strongholds thereof. The Lord has given a commandment. Every commandment of the Lord given on your favor, it will be so.
Amen.
He said he stretched out his hand over the sea.
Yes.
The sea will not be against you.
Amen.
He shook the kingdoms. Every kingdom that want to rise up against you, God will shake them.
Amen.
God will scatter them.
Amen.
God will pull them down.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Kingdom of darkness, kingdom of the wicked, kingdom of the devil, they will come down and crumble in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The Lord will shake the foundation of satanic forces in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And then he says, he will destroy the strongholds thereof. Strongholds. You know what a stronghold is? Something that is holding strong. You can just turn the word around, you will understand. Something that, whatever is holding strong against you, God will uphold them.
Amen.
Whatever power is holding strong against your family, God will pull them down.
Amen.
Every activity of the devil against your life, it will not succeed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You are victorious.
Amen.
You will continue to conquer.
Amen.
The grace of God will not diminish in your life.
Amen.
The power of God will not diminish in your life.
Amen.
God will robe you with authority. God will robe you with power.
Amen.
The enemy will see you are wrong.
Amen.
Jesus said, behold, I beheld the devil. I beheld the serpent. He has fallen down.
Amen.
He has fallen down.
Amen.
Say, Satan has fallen down.
Amen.
Powers of darkness are falling down.
Amen.
The devil has fallen down.
Amen.
The devil has fallen down.
Amen.
Satanic powers are falling down. I tread over them. I tread over them. All the forces of the enemy, I tread over them, over scorpion, over serpent, and every other power of the enemy. And nothing shall by enemies hurt me. Nothing shall by enemies hurt you. May the word of God be accomplished in your life. May that word of God be accomplished in your life. Raise up your hand and let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. According to your word in the book of Isaiah chapter 14, you said in verse 7, the whole earth is at rest and is quiet. They break forth into singing. Father, beginning here in deeper life, at rest. Extending it to our homes, at rest. Extending it to our children who are far away, at rest. Our siblings that are far away, they will come under your rest in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Quietness everywhere.
Amen.
Quietness everywhere.
Amen.
Lord, we silence every voice of the enemy in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, King of glory, we pray. Your people will break forth singing.
Amen.
At the end of these, they will break forth singing.
Amen.
While the enemy is crying and lamenting, your children will be singing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
they will be glorifying you. They will be magnifying you. They will be exalting your name. And the beauty of our God will be all over us. The beauty of heaven will be all over us. We are not of them that turn back unto perdition. We are of them that believe to the saving of the soul. Father, as many as are holding on to the horns, oh Lord Father, to the cross of Christ, Father, I pray, uphold everyone in Jesus' name. We even pray for those who may be falling back. Father, lift them up. Father, don't abandon them. Whatever weaknesses are coming upon them, Father, lift them up. Make them to overcome. Our family without exception, let them break forth in singing. Our church without exemption, we will break forth in singing. Heaven will rejoice on our behalf. As we are singing here, angels of heaven will be singing with us. There will be joy in heaven as there is joy here on earth. Glad tidings of good things in every home. Let it be from now. In the name of Jesus, we banish sorrow, we banish sickness, we banish affliction. We open the door to the joy of the Lord. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Thank you for the answer. Whatever situations are represented under the sound of my voice, either here physically, online, oh Lord Father, I pray, solution now.
Amen.
Solution now.
Amen.
Surprise everyone in Jesus' name. Amen. Let them come back to glorify you. Thank you for the answer. As we go now, let your presence go with us. We have power.
Amen.
We have dominion.
Yes.
We are conquerors in Christ. It shall remain so.
Amen.
For in Jesus' glorious, marvelous, mighty, wonderful name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And the people of God said,
Amen.
Amen.